How to build bridges diagonally in Minecraft. If you're looking to add something a little more organic into your world, there's nothing quite like a bridge. They add a sense of history, they serve a purpose for your survival gameplay, and they're relatively easy to build. My name is Wintertooth100, and today I'm going to build with you 5 unique diagonal bridge designs. Before we jump into building the 5 bridge designs, first I want to go over how to do diagonals in the first place, because what's better than learning how to do a block by block tutorial than actually learning how to build diagonal on your own? Then you can build any bridge design you can think of. Well, it's pretty easy. First, you're just gonna pick any number, basically ranging from 1 to 7. Any bigger than 7, you may as well do just a straight line, because odds are the gap of bridge that you're trying to do is going to, well, it's going to be too short for anything greater than 7. So if you do 7, you can see we have 7 length blocks here. We have them going in both angles. These are essentially the angles you would see in either direction. So if you're standing on the edge of the cliff and the point you're trying to get to is over there, you will use a diagonal that goes obviously to the right. And same thing, if you're trying to get to the left, you'll use a bridge at angles to the left. Same count, easy peasy. You'll notice that the 7s are very straight. In fact, by the time you reach the end, they're only a few blocks apart. 6s, they're a little further apart at the end, and then we got 5s, which are even further, and it starts to get drastic between 5 and 1. So I like to start with 5s and choose between 1 and 5. I don't like to go bigger than 5, because then the diagonal kind of disappears. 4s, you can see, gets even larger. 3s are fairly large. 2s are a huge difference from 3s. So this is another like break point. If you jump from a 3 down to a 2, you're gonna have a much greater angle. And then of course the biggest break point is from 2 to 1. This angle is just the largest diagonal you can get. So essentially when you go through, you're gonna start by picking any one of these angles and framing out where your bridge is gonna go by literally just using these blocks and placing them in. So we are going to start with the natural bridge, and you'll see right away that we are creating a diagonal. These are 3x3s, so you go 3 blocks, move on an angle, go 3 blocks, and we are thickening it up. We want to have a big enough platform to actually be able to use this thing. We want to be able to walk across it, and you know, some players like to have things like horses or, you know, get their animals to follow them, so we want them to be wide enough to actually be usable. That's a big thing, is to make sure that all these bridges are actually functional. We're gonna go ahead and throw some grass on the top just to keep it looking natural. We want the dirt to kind of also be overhanging, and then it's here under the bridge to make it feel really natural. We're gonna create a sort of stalactite, I believe that's the right one, not a stalagmite, where it's hanging. We want it to look natural, like this thing is actually hanging. But for safety's sake, this is a bridge that is a very far drop, and if you're not prepared, that falling from there could unalive a player. So we're going to create some natural barriers along the sides of it. This will basically stop the player from hopefully walking off the edge, and we're just using leaves here, make it seem really natural. We're really leaning into the nature of this as if this formed naturally. And well, we're going to create some pathways to go across it. You can see where this could kind of fit in any natural setting within the world of Minecraft. Here we are again, using the same stone to create an angle. This time it's the same. We're actually doing the 3x3s again. We're going to change it up a little bit here, because I want to do kind of like a rope bridge. And so we're putting in a natural angle in it. So the first thing I did, of course, was to get our angle. Now I'm using that angle as a guide to create a natural swoop, a little swoosh between the two ends of our ravine here. And once we are happy with the shape, we can go through and start replacing the stone with the materials we're going to be using in that rope bridge. And slowly we'll phase out all the stone. You'll see here that I actually made these 5 blocks wide, and I actually changed my mind and trim them down to 3. I felt it was too wide, it took away from the rope bridgey feel. And of course you can't have a rope bridge without some ropes, so on either side I set up a few beams, and using the oak fence I am just kind of, as if they're hanging off the side of the cliff itself, throwing these ropes down and then attaching them to the sides. And well, we want it to look good, so we're just doing a little bit of texturing here with the spruce slabs, and I also go through and we use the spruce trap doors to break up the steps as if it's sort of wearing away. And it's perfectly natural. You can't fall through it unless, of course, you open up one of the trap doors. Now on this one, we're going to actually create an arched bridge, an upward arch. Technically, the last one's a downward arch. And we're doing the same thing again, but this time it's 4 blocks for the diagonal. So we're going to go 4, put a diagonal, and then 4 instead of 3. So we're actually changing it up here. The angle is actually different. And we are going to keep that stone frame, but we're going to replace it with the polished andesite. I think it just looks nice. And here, I've decided to go with the wood logs, and they have a directional texture, so you have to put in a bunch of temporary blocks to be able to line them up correctly. But now we're going through, putting on our little railings on the side. Again, we're thinking about safety for survival mode. We don't want to accidentally walk off of one of these things. And if we jump to the bottom, we want it to feel like this bridge is actually supported. So we're going through, we're adding a couple extra beams, and then we're adding some details underneath to make everything look like it's all connected up, like it's solid. And one of my favorite features about this bridge in particular is at night, this bridge will light up the ravine. We got these posts hanging down, just oak fences, and on the ends of a few of them, not all of them, it's important not to do all of them, we're gonna put a handful of lanterns. And at night, I didn't show it on camera, but at night, this place really glows and it's fantastic. Now, you probably can tell that I've started teaching you guys the angles first because every single one of these bridges is starting with finding the angle. This one is a 5 block angle and we're jumping right into putting in the railings for safety. We don't want anybody accidentally falling off any of our bridges. We are moving right into decorating it. We're gonna put some light posts on this, some lamp posts. I can very much envision this particular bridge being something that you might find within the city walls near a castle, and not something that you might stumble upon out in the fields. We're gonna move under the bridge and start working on the archway. The first thing I've done is locate the rough center of our bridge. We want it to be as centered as possible. And then we are creating the arch itself. We are ignoring the angles for a moment. We really want to nail down the archway's shape. But once we have the shape down, once we're happy with it, we are going to line up every section of the archway with the bridge directly above it. There shouldn't be any part of your archway that does not have a piece of the bridge above it. Next, we're going to move under it between those beams of the archway, and we're going to fill it in with cobblestone, creating a stronger underbelly. This is going to help the bridge feel like it's strong enough to support the weight of anybody who comes across it. Now, this last bridge, I wanted to be a little bit more angled, so we're doing a 2-block angle here. We are thickening it up as we've done with all the others except for the hanging rope bridge. This one, though, I want to do something a little different. I want to make it a ruined bridge, so I've split the middle completely out of it. And now we're just working on making each side feel like it is supported by giving it that nice little arch under it to help support the weight from above. This is, of course, a bridge that you probably won't use a lot, though I personally like to keep them close enough that you can jump from side to side, so it is still technically a functional bridge. You just occasionally will risk falling off of it. Now we're going through, we're doing some heavy details. I really want to go for that ruined look. We're replacing a lot of the materials with cracked stone bricks, mossy cobblestones, and really just ruining this thing as much as we can. We want it to feel like it's been here for a really long time to really sell the idea of this being a ruined bridge. We're even going through with some leaves and giving it a overgrown feel, as if this thing has been here for centuries, that the land itself, the plant life, is overtaking this man-made structure. Again, you should be able to jump from end to end, so it still has some level of functionality. I forgot to capture this on the replay mod, but with your ruined bridge, don't forget to go down below and put in some of the same materials from the bridge in the water or on the land, something. Obviously, if that thing has broken apart and that has fallen off, It had to have gone somewhere, and by putting just a few of them, maybe not even enough blocks that could technically fill the gap, but just a few of them, this will really help your world feel more realistic, really filled with some actual history. I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. This was actually a requested video, and I'm happy to have been able to do this for them. And if you guys have other suggestions for videos you would like to see, let me know in the comments down below, and well, hopefully we can get something made for anybody who has any requests. My name is Wintertooth100. Thank you guys again so much for watching. Be sure to leave a like if you like, subscribe if you haven't, share with your friends, hit that notification bell, and I will see you guys in the next one.